It's the first sneak peek into the new downtown building. The Marilyn I. Walker School of Fine and Performing Arts will be opening its doors this September.
The new building, which combines numerous old buildings and some new additions, some demolition, some new spaces, totals 94,000 square feet. It's an integration of a new theater and new art gallery into the old fabric and corridor spaces to try to take best advantage of the original spaces that were offered to us in the existing building. The wall beside me here that's rubble stone with steel. Other areas have buttressed stone. There's old masonry from each era. There are hardwood floors that where we saved the originals. There are original concrete floors. The deck, the cast iron columns.
Why was it so important to keep those historical elements into a building that's so modern?
The building is modern insofar as we have made additions. We're trying to exhibit and applaud the old spaces and old elements of this building, which create that context for learning for this specific faculty.
So Derek, what does this mean for the Brock Arts?
I think what this means is that we're actually on the cusp of something very new. This is very dramatic. People perhaps are using terms like it's a renaissance of sorts. And what's so important about this is the fact that this really is a center dedicated to the fine and the performing arts. This is an extraordinary commitment, I think, by Brock University. And essentially what I think it what it suggests to me is that we've looked, this is part of a long look forward where we start to imagine students who could be drawn to St. Catharines, to this center, over the next number of years. In fact, perhaps even we might say a generation. So a very, very exciting moment for the university, and particularly for my colleagues in the fine and the performing arts. That in conjunction with the Performing Arts Center, or the First Ontario Performing Arts Center, these are key moments, or platforms, so to speak, when we think about the quality of life, and I think particularly the commitment to cultural activities in general, and in particular, of course, to the university's role in helping revive, so to speak, the downtown.
How does it feel to be walking through the new building that you'll be a part of next year?
I think it feels really, really great, especially since all year we've been getting these photos of what it's supposed to look like, and all the profs have been really enthusiastic about it. So it's really cool and sort of surreal to be just walking through it at this point.
Yeah, it feels incredible. I mean, we've seen so many blueprints, but now it's in 3D, and it's an incredible feeling to find a place where we belong. Like, I mean, in the Glenridge campus, we're kind of in the basement with the drama and music department, just, you know, shoved at the bottom of the school. But this is our building, and we belong here and feel accepted, and it feels good.
What are you most looking forward to about being in this building?
The atmosphere. Like, I think the practice rooms and the rehearsal spaces and where we actually get to perform are just going to be incredible places to play. It makes a huge difference where you are and how it sounds, and it's going to be great to play there.
The completion of this building as the new Marilyn I. Walker School of Fine Performing Arts is not just a huge and very significant accomplishment for Brock University, but we will see in the fall what a grand impact this has on the city of St. Catharines when 50 staff and faculty and 500 students become part of the livelihood of the downtown.
This building will be providing students with an amazing facility to work in and also be revitalizing the city's downtown core. In St. Catharines, reporting for The Source, I'm Vanessa Verwarren.